No way.
Not sure about that.
No way. That's not true.
Oh, the student who's been here for 110 years? Yeah, that rumor's been going around for a while. I think it's just one of those things. But a couple of years ago, everybody thought Miley Cyrus applied. Come on.
Wouldn't that make him 130?
Well, with the right styling, it's possible.
I don't know, man. I've seen some pretty weird stuff.
I will neither confirm nor deny.
It's not true.
I suppose with the right exercise and nutrition program, it's possible.
Rumors of a man who's been a Point Loma student since its foundation 110 years ago have been circulating since the early 1930s. People have been trying to hunt down the truth for decades.
Oh, that's definitely possible. Our alums have very good genes.
But there has never been proof that he exists.
Where are the transcripts?
Tell us the truth!
Until today.
Shannon, I've been waiting for you. I knew this day was coming. Come, let's fellowship together.
Wow. Chip, so you've been here the whole time.
I sure have. Student ID number 6.
Wow. Wow. Well, why now? I mean, why did you choose to go public tonight?
You didn't really give me much of a choice. I mean, you literally broke into my home with a camera crew.
That's true. I mean, I know the reason, but... what's the reason?
Well, when I heard it was the 110-year celebration, I thought to myself, Chip, who better to kick this off than you? I mean, you owe it to the people, you owe it to your 282,000 classmates, so here I am.
That's true. I mean, I'm sure you've been around to see Point Loma go through a lot of changes over
the years. Yeah, I sure have seen a lot. But one thing that hasn't changed are high-quality comedy musicians. I mean, since the very beginning, we've had the finest musical comedians.
That's true. And here now, to continue that century of greatness, with a song penned just for the Big 110, 09 and 010 alums, Megan Bryan.
Boy, howdy, that was, sure was a good act, wasn't it?
It was, wasn't it?
You know, I was part of the Melody Men back in... 59 mm-hmm. and 62 through 65 and 60. That's me right there. I was Chet Patton at the time. I don't think the guys remember me. Huh. I started running out of good wigs, and I think they started to catch on.
Yeah, I understand. I mean, it's hard to have enough quality good wigs, but I'm sure you were involved in a lot over the years.
Yeah, much like our next act, I was involved in the world of poetry mm-hmm. and track and field. In fact, I think, that's me up there too.
Uh-huh. Going through some physical changes.
Yeah, it's kind of an awkward time. Yeah. You can take those down.
Well, you did good, though. I mean, you really blended in. You flew under the radar pretty well.
Had to work pretty hard, but, you know, speaking of track and field, poetry, and hard work, we're proud to introduce Jason O'Neill, 2004 alum, Point Loma track star, here to share some of his original poetry.
So, Chip, now that the secret's out, we have to know, how did you pull it off?
You know, Shannon, it...
Is that a pipe?
Oh yeah, this whole thing about this, like, since the 50s.
I have that here.
Oh, okay, sorry about that. You know, I just worked out a lot. You know, changed my style, changed mustaches a lot. You know, bleached my hair, cut it, froed it, all that good stuff. Really, just did my best to blend in.
Was there ever a time that you thought you might get caught?
Yeah, there were a couple of times.
Chuck Picking, man. He reminds me of this guy we had to kick off campus a while ago for living in Goodwin for, well, since before I was here.
Cool beans.
Yo, Dr. K, that lecture was out of sight. Catch you on the flip side.
Dr. K, who was that guy?
I think his name was Champ Hopkin. He reminds me of somebody, but I can't put my finger on it.
You will.
Yeah, so this is his profile, Chad Pitten. I don't recall seeing his application. Do you think he's a readmit?
I don't know. Seems like a dweeb.
Talking about those mustaches.
Yeah, you'd be surprised what a distraction a mustache can make.
You know, if you wanted, you could just call it a mustraction.
Yeah, I guess I could, but I probably
wouldn't
want to.
Speaking of mustractions, you may have been mustracted by our last act, the piano stylings of Mr. Salinas, but you certainly should not be mustracted by our next act, current senior Annie Miller.
Man, that was a boss act.
Uber boss, Chip. But listen, doesn't seeing a fresh-faced young student like Cousin Kyle up here doing his thing, doesn't it make you feel a little old to be a current student?
What are you getting at?
Listen, not to be mean, but now that we know about you, we kind of have to take you into account in all of our data, and you're messing up our four-year graduation rate. See, here's the thing. Here's our four-year grad rate normally. We're doing pretty well. We're about 20 points higher than a state school. Here's our four-year grad rate with you.
Yeah.
Right?
I guess you're right. I guess I need to think about the next step here.
Yeah. Well, why don't you take the time through this next act to think about what's going on.
So Chip, it's been 110 years, everybody knows who you are, and your dorm has been condemned by the physical plant, so what's next?
You know, Shannon, that's a good question. When I started as a student here in 1902, I never had the intention of staying this long. You know, I learned a lot while I was here, and when I was about to graduate, I just thought, why would I ever want to leave this awesome community? So I just figured out ways I could stay. Over the years, I've had 62 majors, 32 minors, 18 concentrations, and seen the school change its name 8 times. I've seen the KBA turn into the Commons, the Tank turn into the Academic Support Center, and I've seen hot sauce initiations go from okay to definitely not okay. But you're right. You know, I think it's time for me to move on. So, I think maybe I'll look for a job where I can put my love of Point Loma and vast experience to good use. I think I've got a good lead.
Hey Chip, are you ready for your admissions counselor interview?
I sure am.
All right, come
Let's
on
do
in.
It.
Okay.
Gentlemen, your MCs. Shannon Hutchison, and PLNU's newest admissions counselor, Chip Pitkin.
Congratulations, Chip, on your new position. Are you excited?
Oh, excited? I finally have a reason never to leave this place.
You did it.
Let's get out of here. If we don't die.
I can't really see.
Okay.